Hi everyone, this is another one problem based on a bar element, that is a taper bar element. But our question, it is clearly shows for a taper plate of uniform thickness T equal to 10 mm as shown in figure. So this figure is a taper plate, similarly taper bar. For simplicity, here we go to convert taper bar into stepped bar. And so here this taper bar, first taper bar is converted into stepped bar for simplicity, and this stepped bar is divided into two elements, element 1 and element 2, total 3 nodes, node 1, node 2, node 3. Element 1 have 2 nodes, node 1 and 2. Element 2 have 2 nodes, node 2 and 3. The point load is act at node 2, that is 10 kN, and the total length of the bar is 300 mm. So each element carries length 150 mm and 150 mm. So first here we go to find the area of node 1, area of node 2 and area of node 3, and here average area of element 1, average area of element 2. That's the first step. First here we go to find the area at node 1. Area at node 1, that is A1 equal to W1 into T. T is nothing but thickness. So W1 equal to AT into thickness 10, that is equal to 800 mm square. A1. Next one, area at node 2. Area at node 2, that is area at node 3. A3 equal to W3 into T, that is W3 equal to 40 into 10, that is equal to 400 mm square. Next one, area at node 2, area at node 2, that is A2 equal to A1 plus A2 divided by, A1 plus A3 divided by 2, that is equal to A1 equal to 800 plus 400 divided by 2, that is equal to 600 mm square. Average area of element 1. Average area of element 1, that is A1 bar. A1 bar equal to A1 2 divided by 2. So A1 equal to 800, A2 equal to 600, 800 plus 600 divided by 2 equal to 700 mm square. Average area of element 2, average area of element 2, A2 bar equal to A2 plus A3 divided by 2. That is equal to A2 equal to 600, A3 equal to 400. 600 plus 400 divided by 2, A2 bar equal to 500 mm square. So in our question, that is the find the displacement at the node by forming into two element model. The bar has mass density. So mass density is given. Mass density rho equal to 7800 kg per meter cube. That's the mass density. Then Young's modulus E equal to 2 into 10 raised to 5 mega newton per meter square. Mega means 10 raised to 6. So into 10 raised to 6 into Newton per meter square. Per meter square into Newton per millimeter square. So into minus 6 Newton per mm square. Because meter is converted into millimeter is into 10 cube. Meter square is converted into millimeter square into 10 power 6. So 10 power 6 mm square. Meter square into millimeter square is 10 power 6 mm square. This 10 power 6 in the numerator, this 10 power 6 will become 10 power minus 6. Therefore, 10 power 6 into 10 power minus 6. So, it is cancelled. Finally, 2 into 10 raised to 5 newton per mm square. The next one, in addition to self-weight, the plate is subjected to a point load at its center, also determine the reaction force at the support. So, therefore, here it is consider self-weight. Consider self-weight and thickness t equal to 10 mm. So here we go to find displacements at each nodal points. Displacements at each nodal point. And second one, reaction, support reaction force. Solution. The finite element equation for bar element is given by the finite element equation for finite element equation for bar element is given by F equal to K into U, or F is the body force vector, K is the element stiffness matrix, and U is the nodal displacement. So F1, F2 equal to A E by L 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 U1 U2. Body force vector is given by body force vector is given by F1, F2 equal to W A1 A bar L by 2 1 1. Here W is the weight density. So weight density W equal to rho into g. Rho equal to 7800 into g is the acceleration due to gravity 9.81. So 7800 into 9.81 equal to 76518. Unit of weight function is, weight density is newton per meter cube. So I already told you, meter is converted into millimeter is into 10 power 3. So meter cube is converted into 10 power meter cube is converted in millimeter cube equal to 10,000 cube, that is 10 power 9. And this 10 power 9 into the numerator, that is 10 power minus 9. Therefore 76518 into 10 power minus 9 newton per millimeter cube. So unit conversion is very important. Therefore finally 7.6518 into 10 power minus 5 newton per mm cube. For element 1, body force vector is F1, F2 equal to W A1 bar L1 by 2, 1, 1. So W equal to 7.6518 into 10 power minus 5 into A1 bar equal to 700 into L1 equal to 150 divided by 2, 1, 1. Solve this equation. We will get 4.017, 1, 1. And F2 equal to 4.017. For element 2, there is a node 2 and 3, therefore F2, F3 equal to W A2 bar L2 divided by 2, 1, 1. W equal to 7.6518 into 10 power minus 5 into 500 into 150 divided by 2, 1. So solve this equation, we will get 2.869, 1. Then F2, F3 equal to 2.869, 2.869. Assembled force vector. Point load P is act at node 2. That is P equal to 10 kilonewton. Therefore, F1, F2, F3 equal to, we know F1, F2 equal to 4.017, 4.017. F2, F3 equal to 2.869. So assemble these two equations, you will get F1 4.017, F2 equal to 4.017 plus 2.869 plus 10,000 into 10 cube. F3 equal to 2.869. So summation of this term, you will get F1, F2, F3. Equal to 4.017, 4.017 plus 2.869 plus 10 into 10 cube, that is 10 kilonewton, kilo means 10 cube, so 10 into 10 cube newton. So summation of these three terms, you will get 2.869. And next here we go to find the finite element equations. For element 1, F1, F2 equal to A1 bar E by L1, 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1, U1, U2. So A1 bar equal to 700 into 2 into 10 raised to 5 by 115, 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1, U1, U2. So that is equal to 9.3 into 10 power 5, 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1, U1, U2. So therefore, F1, F2 equal to 10 raised to 5, 9.3 minus 9.3 minus 9.3, U1, U2. So for element 1, there is 2 node, 1 and 2, therefore here I give 1, 2, 1, 2. For element 2, F2, F3 equal to A2 bar E by L2, 1 minus 1 minus 1, U2, U3. So 500 into 2 into 10 raised to 5. Divided by 150, 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1, U2, U3. Solve this equation, we will get 6.67 into 10 raised to 5, 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1, U2, U3. Therefore, F2, F3 equal to 10 raised to 5, 6.67 minus 6.67, 6.67, minus 6.67, 6.67. Then assemble the final element equation into U2, U3. Assemble finite element equation into global equation, that is F1, F2, F3 equal to, here the coefficient of matrix is, stiffness matrix is 10 raised to 5 for 2 elements. The coefficient of stiffness matrix should be same, then only we can assemble the equation. So here the coefficient of stiffness matrix for both 2 elements is, element 1 and element 2 is 10 raised to 5, 10 raised to 5. So therefore there is no issue, 10 raised to 5. And here we put 2, 3. Therefore, here we put 1, 2, 3, U1, U2, U3, 1, 2, 3. So, 9.3, 2, 1, minus 9.3, 3, 1, there is no 3, 1, therefore, here simply we put dash, 1, 2, minus 9.3, 2, 2, 9.3. And come to the second element, 2, 2, 6.67. Therefore, plus 6.67, minus 6.67, dash, minus 6.67, 6.67. Therefore, F1 equal to 4.017. F2 equal to 2.869 equal to 10 raised to 5, 9.3 minus 9.3, 0, minus 9.3, for dash simply we put 0, minus 9.3, 15.97, minus 6.67, 0, minus 6.67, 6.67, U1, U2, U3. Next step, apply boundary conditions. Apply boundary conditions. So, in this figure, the node 1 is fixed. Therefore, U1 equal to 0 because node 1 is fixed. Node 1 is fixed. And so therefore, here we go to apply the boundary conditions. So therefore, 4.017, 1000, 6.886, 2.869. Equal to 10 raised to 5, 9.3, minus 9.3, 0, minus 9.3, 15.97, minus 6.67, 0, minus 6.67, 6.67. So U1 equal to 0, U2, U3. So here U1 equal to 0, therefore here we go to strike out the first row and first column. And this matrix form is converted into the simultaneous equation form. So that is 15.97 into 10 raised to 5 U2 minus 6.67 into 10 raised to 5 U3 equal to 1000 6.886. And minus 6.67 into 10 raised to 5 U2 plus 6.67 into 10 raised to 5 U3 equal to 2.869. Solve these two equations by using calculator. So solve above two equations we will get. Solve above equation we get U2 and U3. So by using calculator, here we go to find U2 and U3. So simply press mode 3 times, 1, 2, 3,
and one for equation 1. And here equation 1, and here 2 unknown, here we go to find 2 unknown, that is u2 and u3, therefore plus 2. And a1 equal to 15.97 into 10 raised to 5. So therefore 15.97 into 10 raised to 5. B1 equal to minus 6.667 into 6.67 into 10 raised to 5. And C1 equal to 10,006.886. And A2 equal to minus 6.67 into 10 raised to 5. B2 equal to 6.67 into 10 raised to 5. And C2 equal to 2.869. We will get X, that is U2 equal to 0.10763. U3 equal to 0.010674. So U2 equal to 0.010763 mm, and U3 equal to 0.010767 mm. So this is the nodal displacement for two nodes. Next, here we go to find the reaction support, reaction force at suppose. To find reaction force at support, that is R equal to K U star minus F. It is R1, R2, R3 equal to 10 raised 9.3, -9.3, 0, -9.3, 15.97, -6.67, 0, -6.67, 6.67. U1 equal to 0, U2 equal to 0.010763, U3 equal to 0.010767, minus F equal to 4.017, 10006.886, and 2.869. Solve these equations, you will get R1, R2, R3 equal to -10004.017 newton, R2 equal to -6.886 newton, R3 equal to -2.869. Here, this one is 3 by 3 matrix, this is 3 by 1 matrix. So, multiply these two matrix and subtract with this matrix, you will get the final answer. Thank you.